What is the connection between joy and discipleship? That is a question posed by When the Song of the Angels is Stilled, a famous poem by Howard Thurman set to music by Elizabeth Alexander. Reverend Howard Thurman was a theologian, professor, prolific author, and civil rights leader. He taught at Morehouse and Spelman Colleges, was the first dean of Howard University's Rankin Chapel, and was the first Black dean of Boston University's Marsh Chapel. From 1944 until 1953, he was founding co-pastor of the Church for the Fellowship of All Peoples in San Francisco, the first interracial and interfaith congregation in the United States. When the Song of the Angels is Stilled is one of Thurman's most recognizable poems, in which he connects the joy of Christmas with the challenging work of discipleship that the Incarnation demands. Reverend Dr. Luke Powery, the Dean of Duke Chapel and a scholar of Thurman's work, says that, quote, "The voice and wisdom of Howard Thurman call us to remember who Jesus was and what Jesus did, with his emphasis on the disinherited. He calls the church to follow Jesus and find him among the lost, the broken, the hungry, and the prisoner, because this is how nations are rebuilt. Peace is created and real music made." As it was for Thurman, it should be true for us, that today's church should focus its ministry on those whose backs are against a wall. If not, we are not the Church of Jesus Christ, who himself was disinherited and had his back against a cross. Dr. Elizabeth Alexander was raised in North Carolina and Ohio and currently resides in St. Paul, Minnesota. Her many commissioned works include pieces for orchestra, chamber ensembles, and solo instruments, but she is best known for her choral music, which has been performed all over the world. Her many awards include recognitions from the McKnight Foundation, the New York Council on the Arts, the American Composers Forum, and the International League of Women Composers. In her setting of Thurman's text, Alexander uses the bright key of D major and a repeated rhythmic motive of quarter note triplets to depict the exuberant joy of the Christmas message. In contrast, she employs minor chords and a surprising lowered sixth scale degree in describing the work that Christmas calls us to do. The phrases "the work of Christmas," or its variant "the work begins," are repeated a total of 12 times throughout the anthem. As the piece concludes, Alexander repeats the first four lines of the poem, but in reverse order. This sets up a juxtaposition of the poem's first and fifth lines, and gently drives home this point. When the celebration is over, when the song of the angels is stilled, the work of Christmas begins.